my son. I mean, what you know, the reason for being, right, to be the best influence that I can be to my son, has to be my God, obviously. And I think with my faith, it's about being a servant leader. Whatever you do, you have to serve, to lead. And who are number three? I was just having a chat this morning with some people, and I have to say, it's also my mom, as in, she never stopped me in whatever I wanted to do, right? Maybe because I was the youngest or whatever, but you know, it never stopped me. If I wanted to do this, I wanted to do that, I've never been, oh, you can't do this, you can't do that. So I've never had that lid put on me. So, yeah. Simple. It's the most influential people, right? It's your mothers and your teachers. These people are the ones that are going to impact your life. Forget all the big guys, the ones closest to home. Pet peeves. It's the same as Regina's. I hate people being late. I hate waiting. Yeah, I hate people being late. I hate waiting for people. I don't do that to people. If I need to be late or whatever, I will keep people informed. All right, so that would be a pet peeve. High heels, darling. I wrote the book.
Yes. Who knows? There are different days.
High heels, high heels. It's bad, but never mind. Wow. I'll say a place that I keep on going a lot is Bali. I love Bali. I mean, I've been around the world. I mean, I love Santorini, I love all these things, but I guess the closest, the cheapest. Favorite food, as a Malaysian, there is too many. There is no favorite food lah, but if put me to a corner, no lah. Serak laksa, I love it. You know, it depends lah. I mean, that's the beauty of this country. Every day you can decide you want to eat something else.
True, too many choices.
Too many choices, yeah. Someone alive. who will it be? Anthony Robbins. I just want to know what drives him and how he's that one person that I haven't met yet. The person that I have met and I wish I could sit down and have dinner with him is Nick Wojcic. I've interviewed him, but you know, it's an interview, but I think to sit down to have a heart-to-heart conversation, it'd be really interesting. I am not obsessed with TV shows. I don't have time for TV shows.
Because you are in it, right? You are on TV.
Once upon a time. But I just find that I love TV a lot, and when I get started, I will be addicted. The last time I was addicted to something was many, many years ago. Maybe you weren't born. Was X-Files. Dulu. So anyway, so that was when it just occupied my life and all that. So it's too easy right now. But once in a while for comic relief, I'll go and watch Modern Family.
Oh, okay. Yes.
Some advice to your younger self, be patient. Be patient. Don't be in a hurry. You know, yeah. Just things. Some things happen at a certain pace. Some things happen at a slower pace. Don't be in a hurry.
I know you are Beaver music, but yeah.
Hi, Beaver. Best song on the radio at the moment is the problem. At the moment, lagu lama maybe lah. At the moment, what am I singing along? Pass. I can't. Not at the moment. Give me some songs.
Everybody's talking about.
We don't always play the latest songs.
Yeah.
That's the thing. You see, we play nice songs. Okay. I guess the latest would be, it's not being played on radio, but David Bowie's last single. Which emoji? The one with the smiley.
Oh,
yeah. The ability to choose without someone controlling, dictating what you want to choose. If you want to choose to be a housewife, that's it. But it was your choice. If you chose to work, it's your choice and not someone telling you what to do. That's feminism.
Perfect Friday night.
The perfect Friday night is staying in, actually. Staying in. Or if it's a good movie, but usually my Friday nights are occupied with study. Bible study. Ngaji. Okay, the book that I have just finished reading is called, this year anyway, called Never Look Back, 10 Reasons that You Should Never Look Back On by Dr. Harry Cloud. Three qualities of a leader. Persistence, only persistence. The ability to communicate, to share your vision. And I think to know when to be tough and when to be gentle. That's a tough one. Because you know, sometimes you can't be all gentle all the time. And there's a time to be tough. And that's tough. My guilty pleasures. It's not chocolate either. It's not chocolate. I mean, if you give me, I love it. But if you say, no guilty pleasures. I love sweet stuff. In general, sweet tooth. If I can go anywhere right now, I want to go to Mykonos. I've never been there. Santorini, but not Mykonos. I haven't been there.
Do you have a superpower?
Oh, mind control, darling. Mind control. Listen to me.
Brilliant, yeah.
Oh, no, I didn't think about the superhero name. Adventurer. Diamonds are handbags. Diamonds can sell, buy more handbags. I'm a Chinese. Diamonds.
Diamonds, my choice.
Oh, my dream car. actually, I've got very small dreams. Like, okay, I love my car, which is a Beetle. It's cute, but I love the Z4. Both got attitude.
Do you have any superhero in mind that you
superhero,
like?
Superhero. Iron Man's kind of cool. Wolverine's kind of cool. So yeah, there's so many. How to say most embarrassing? Okay, this is the most recent one. It's not the most embarrassing. I've got a very nice neighbor, right? I've been living. We've been neighbors for about 4 or 5 years. Very nice couple. Very nice. And every time I see him, I say hi, Francis. So yesterday I used a Grab car, and the Grab car driver turned out to be his brother-in-law. So we're talking. I say, hey, you know my brother-in-law? I said, yeah, Francis. No, his name is Tony. Calling Tony Francis.
And he acknowledged. He's such a sweet man.
Yeah.
He's like, okay, yeah.
I hate it when people say, I hate it when people say there is a problem and they don't give me a possible solution. It's always a solution. None at the moment. Because I love my pets and I've had pets die, and it's very heartbreaking. And if I were to get a pet, it would be a dog, and I would adopt one, and I won't get any ones. But it's very heartbreaking. And I love my dogs, so my son.
At the moment, and maybe the third book.
The third book is called Inspire Yourself. Education should not be politicized. Education should be free, right? That to me is important. Equal salaries for both genders, right? Must go. What? What are the three things? Okay, inequality needs to go. Housing for all, you know? And I think access to basic infrastructure like housing and transportation. Sometimes I beat myself to, you know, like, impatience. The last film I watched was Kung Fu Panda 3. With my son.
Yes.
What's the first thing? Their smile.
That's
very important. It's very important.
Okay. Too many.
No special talent. I think to communicate. You know, I think that was a gift that was given when I was young, whether it's through speaking or through writing, and the ability to I was just talking to someone yesterday, to make the complex simple. I would, you know, and that's the power of communication. No need to have all the flowery words. Every day I learn something. Every day I meet someone that I can learn from, right? And just the, and it's so close to my house. Yeah, it's so close. Yeah. And the energy at the workplace. Yeah. My girl crush, I just like her because she's so funny. Sofia Vergara, la. Funny. Very lovely, very funny, is it? Yeah. It'll be some Taiwanese movie that my cousin brought me to. I can't remember. Something that I remember will probably be the first Superman. Way back when. The hardest, when you become mother or a parent, your kids are watching you. And you're always wondering, because you can tell them to do certain things, but it's your behavior that they will model. So I'm always worried, am I the best example for my son? So that's the thing. Sometimes you always, so everything you say, everything you do, he's watching, which is scary. I can give the gift of childbirth. It would have to be that. Because also you hear a lot of stories where people have a problem having children and all that. It's such a wonderful gift of life to be able to experience that joy, that, you know. So far he's been a joy.
So far.
My time. I know a lot of people like to meet in groups and all that, you know, so I always say, can we meet one-on-one and have tea and talk? I find that that's the best, that's how you develop relationships, one-on-one. Oh, you too! Okay, so I've seen them in concert already, so bucket list da. Okay, you too. I asked my parents how they got their name, they say they can't remember. Saja. Kind of cute. I got two moods. There's the neat mood, and then there is the creative mood. Yeah.
Creative.
I call it creative lah. It's horrible, but anyway. Depending on angin.
You were another person who would be friends with?
Almost definitely. Who do I miss most currently? My dad.
Favorite spot to watch?
I love watching tennis.
Oh, favorite spot that you play?
Favorite? I run.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, sunbathing for sure. Mountain climbing is susah lah. I have a lot lah, depending on what size I am. The wedding dress was nice, I guess. Okay, I don't have designer shoes. I am wearing this very funky pair from Zalf, Z-A-L-F. So I've got a funky pair. Yeah. I was born in Brunei, a small little town in Brunei called Syria. You've been to Syria? Okay, I was born in the house.
Oh. Okay.
Adventurous, committed, and loyal.
Tea, coffee.
Coffee. 6:30. Favorite comedian? I love all these comedians that have no depth, like, as in they're just funny, the Will Ferrells, the Jack Blacks, the Ben Stillers, you know, just no favorite, but they all, you know, just, I know, stupid comedy, I love it. Phobia. I don't understand why I need to bungee jump. I don't see the point. I know I'll be freaked out. I just don't see the joy of... It's not on my bucket list, lah.
Okay.
Yeah. Women should look out for a woman. Women should look out for each other, right? And that's... But I think that's also human nature, that you should just look out for each other and bring out the best in each other. Like I mentioned those things about, are we getting equal pay? Child is family is... The whole idea of if you're a man and you're married, raising a family is the job of both of you. It's not just when the child is sick that the woman has to take off, right? So it's raising the child takes both individuals, especially if both are working, right? So it should be the raising of a, it's got to be, then the kid will see mom and dad were equally involved, and that's how they lead by example. Okay, the phone's outside. Lipstick and then a pen.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, yeah, done for the day.